Hello there, and welcome to Age of Empires, the Rise of Rome expansion, which is just essentially Age of Empires 1. I'm going to be playing through all of the campaigns, and I'm going to type ChrizmanTV into the name box, and we're going to crack straight on with Ascent of Egypt learning campaign, and the first mission is hunting, and I've got the difficulty set to moderate. Even though for this it doesn't matter. Wow, a dramatic cutscene there. So our first mission objective is to create 7 villages. And it gives you a few hints there. But I know what I'm doing. But the trick is just to get close to them and then they don't really run off very far. You gotta watch out for the alligators, though. That's the only enemy on this map. In later ones, you get lions. And then eventually, entire civilizations. But, that's all still to come. Just a bit of background on Age of Empires. While he's collecting food. It's an RTS by Ensemble Studios. It was made between 1995 and 1997. It was heavily influenced by Sid Meier's Civilization. It was originally called Dawn of Man. Come on, those were two direct hits. And in my opinion, this game is not the best of the series. But it is still one of the classics. I suppose it's quite obvious, really, that the best, in my opinion, is Age of Empires 2 HD. But the original Age of Empires 2 was amazing. And I I was playing that about a decade ago. I was playing this a decade ago as well. I always thought the second one was better. And now they've done a HD version, so... with 2 new expansions, incidentally. So there's even more of a reason to buy it. Gotta watch for those alligators. Here he comes. Yeah, just stand there, why don't you? Yeah. That was quite stupid of him. Although I suppose the intelligence levels of prehistoric man is not exactly up to the standards of today. Don't see any of these people with iPhones. We're gonna have to build a house to support population. The town centre can support 4 people. Houses are also 4, so it works cumulatively. So town centre plus 1 house means 8 people, or 8 units rather. How many will that be? That'll be 6, so it's 1 more after that. This game can get incredibly difficult, but I hope that by keeping it on moderate, it's not going to be too difficult. I'm currently watching someone on YouTube who's playing this, but they're playing it on hardest. I've spent possibly 2 or 3 days just watching all that, and I'm victorious. But, yeah, it does look insanely difficult at times. Well, that was hunting. And we're keeping it on moderate. So foraging is the next mission. Build a storage pit, a granary, and a dock. Sounds simple. I might slow it down, the game speed, when like big battles are taking place, perhaps. I don't know. Who knows? Who knows what the future holds? Although it's fairly prescripted, given that it's a 12-scenario campaign, so you can't really deviate from that. I'm going to try something with the birds in a moment, which I imagine is a kind of... I don't know why it happens, but... the eagles particularly, and I think the hawks as well, blow up. They just explode if you shoot at them. Excuse me. So I'm going to get a villager, and I'm going to blow up the birds. Can we try it? Come on. These ones are small. No. It's easier to do it with the eagles. Although I have done it with the hawks before. This tree that the... and we need... I only wanted one of them. I need more houses. All this will do is speed it along. Gonna get him over here. Ah, there we go. Got it. So that's on. Put that villager on wood over there. Get another one. I'm gonna put a storage pit over here, a dock over here, and a granary anywhere else, really. Given that it's really not. Come on, shoot it. There we go. He can build the dock. That gets addictive. I'm not gonna lie. Okay. there. We can have one more villager after this. You can build the storage pit. And you can go over there. Sorry, what? What? Seriously, that one was closer. And you chose that one. Right. Granary is the only thing that is needed now. I'm not going to build. Sorry, I'm not going to create any more villagers. Right. Got five of them to build it, there's no real point. There we go, we are victorious again. I'm not going to read these because they do get quite extensive, the aftermaths. I mean, surely you can pause it to see what it says. Discoveries. This was the one that I messed up on, and it was a stupid mistake. I didn't know where anything was. Right. I'm going to keep two of them on food. I'm going to get one other person just to walk around and find the discoveries. There's one of them down here that is very close to a lion. That's fairly okay to deal with. I'll send him up the top. Are you serious? You're going the wrong way. Come on, there we go. Right, now I'm going to keep him up there for just a moment. Because I need to distract the horse scout that is roaming in that area, whilst at the same time right, let's go for it. Right, okay, he's going for this. Just get up there now, come on. And he's dead. He is most definitely dead. Oh, brilliant, come on. You absolute idiot. Way! I'm not defeated yet. Now we can walk together to the last discovery. That wasn't exactly how I intended it to go. And actually, that's probably worse than how the trial run went. Ha! Running away from me. Ah, Christ, he's back. I have defeated everybody. All the lions are dead. The horse scout is dead. And I have emerged victorious. Okay, this one is advanced to the tall age. Now we need two stone age buildings and I think 500 food. Yes. So therefore Yeah, and dock in a storage pit. Thanks for giving me help. Right, get round there. Excellent. This is a very efficient way of generating food to start with. So that's going to give you quite a lot. He needs to be on wood. Because we need a house. You need to build more houses. You need to stop being so patronizing. It's 30 for a house, isn't it? Yes. Let's have two of them lined up. Excellent. Oh, it's just got rid of one of the trees. And back to wood. And they're finished. Right. Well, that's great, because... Actually, just clear that out. This. We can't do anything without wood, so... Wood. Start bashing those cheese is what I was about to say. Start bashing those trees. Excellent. Okay, we've got enough for a dock. Which we can't put anywhere, apparently. I think if you kill an elephant... You have to put a storage pit near it. I don't think it's a granary. I think granaries are just for forage bushes. And that has gone incredibly loud in my ear. Ouch. Let's just have... What? Not enough wood. Yes, there is. You're lying. And then we can always... Well, actually, yeah, we could just use fishing boats. To, there better be fish out here. Yeah. Alright, stop scattering. Just go over to one place. You need to build more houses. This is gonna go up in seconds. While we're at it. This probably isn't the best way of doing it, but it's the way I'm doing it. And now we need... Well, we need either a storage pit or whatever it is we want. Okay. Right, let's build the storage pit first. The most pedantic of people. Not enough wood. Realistically, make them get food. I probably should. I've forgotten where the elephants are. Put that wood in the storage pit, please. Right. I think there's one up here, actually. There he is. This is now a very inefficient land-based food system. But ah well. Nearly there. And that's that. We're advancing up. Pathfinding in this game is not the greatest. A lot of time is spent waiting. Things to age up, and there's a little bit of corrupt land there. That's not supposed to be square like that. It's got squared edges. And I am victorious again. And I think, for now, I will call the episode to an end. So I will see you next time when we play Skirmish, which sounds incredibly deadly. So I'll see you then. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to leave a like and a comment. Don't forget to subscribe and check out my social media, the links to which can be found in the description below. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.